In this video, we're going to look at how to create this a simple latte title. Let's get started. First, we need a solid clip. So, in the project bin, right-click, add a color clip. You can change the color from here. And once we have that, we want to bring this to the timeline. And then you can zoom in more by Command or Control and the middle mouse button. Now, let's go to the effect and apply the crop by padding. Once you have that, now we need to crop this down. So you can see the handles at the end here, at the poke corner. You can just click and drag to crop it down. Using the circle there with the X in the center there, and drag it and place it in the center that you want to create your little animation of. Okay, so let's place this on the right on the center there. Now with that, you can see here we have the radius. Now what happened is, if we crank this all the way up, you can see it made a nice round curve at the two end of the clip. If you go down the center, it's only did partly of that on the edge. So I like something like that, or you can have it all like the straight cut edge. The second thing is to create our text. So to create our text, go back again to the project bin, do a right click, and then add a title clip. Once we have that, now we can create our text. Type in our text. Grab your text and place it in here. Now let's create the title. Let's bring the text clip to the timeline, and you can see this is what we have now. Now it's time for the animation. First, let's animate the solid. To animate the solid, first we want to make the solid disappear and then come on the screen again. To do that, it's all in the crop by padding. So in the width, click and drag to trim off all this down, something like that. And then on the Y, let's hide the little solid clip there. So on X axis, click and drag it to hide it somewhere there. Now let's bring our playhead and place it somewhere here. This time we need to add a keyframe. So adding the keyframe, now from the X value, we want to bring our text back in again. So we want to have something like that. And then move our playhead somewhere here, add another keyframe, and then go to the width, and then let's bring back the crop clip again to show that. Once we have that, now it's time for the text animation. So let's drag our playhead here, select our clip here. You can either just trim this to create this nice pop-up, or you can use transform to create the animation. If you want to use the transform, let's place the playhead somewhere here, and then let's apply the transform effect. Come to the effect, transform. You can always set here to get the transform. I have already saved it to my favorites here, so let's select the transform and apply to it. And then I want to hide the text at the vertical up here. So from the Y, I go the opposite way and hide the text right out there. Now selecting the solid clip and see where the last keyframe is. Bring the playhead a little bit over that. Then select the text, add a keyframe, and then from the Y, bring back our text to be displayed on our little solid color clip here. Okay, so this is what we have now. You can make it faster, but for the purpose of this video, we slow it down. And now the outro. To have the outro, the first thing is to have the text disappeared. So let's add a keyframe and then move the playhead a little bit like that. Add another keyframe and then let's hide the text to go underneath like that. Let's move the playhead again. Select the solid clip, add a keyframe, move it somewhere there, add another keyframe. And then from the width or W there, let's trim the little save here all the way down like that. And then move the playhead, add another keyframe, and then from the X, let's hide the little solid. Okay, that's all we need, and let's check it out. So you can see our animation is not steady. Instead of it's steady, you can see it's moving out in the screen there. So what we need to do is change the interpolation. So first, we need to change for the clip the keyframe interpolation. So when we select each of this keyframe, you can see here we have the keyframe interpolation. So change this to linear. Make sure to do the same for all the keyframe, either on the solid clip or on the text. Now once we complete that, now let's play the animation again. Okay, so that's all for this video. Thank you for watching.